Hello, I'm Arka, and today I will be presenting Video Semantic Role Labeling with Chitto Dataset, which is a guest task at ActivityNet Challenge workshop at CVPI 21. This is a joint work with Tanmay Gupta, Mark Yatskar, my advisor Ram Nivashya, and Anuruddha Kembhavi. Using this video as an example, let's consider what makes video understanding so challenging and interesting. First, it has multiple interacting objects, like the woman with the shield, the shirtless man, and so on. Second, the way these objects interact change over time. In one instance, a person throws something, and in the next, someone is jumping. Third, these interactions affect each other. Someone punches, which results in the other falling down. This brings us to our key idea. We formalize the above notion and propose the task of visual semantic role labeling in videos or video semantic role labeling. Specifically, we propose three tasks under video semantic role labeling. First is verb prediction, where we assign a verb sense to identify the most salient thing happening within the event, such as deflect, talk, or leap. Second is semantic role prediction, where given a verb, such as deflect, one has to identify the entities participating, such as the woman with the shield or the boulder, as well as the roles played by them, which is argument 0, argument 1. And finally, coreference these entities across events, that is, identify that it is the same woman in both events. And third is event relation prediction, where given two events, one classifies how the two affect each other, such as via a causal relation or a precondition. This brings us to VidC2, a dataset specifically designed for video SRL. Each video is 10 seconds long, taken from a movie, and annotated at 2-second interval. Importantly, the semantic role information is collected directly at annotation time and not via any post-processing steps. An obvious question is why annotate at only 2-second intervals? In our preliminary investigations, we find that compared to annotating with start and end times, annotating with fixed 2-second intervals usually simplifies the task, leading up to 3 times speed up in time as well as cost, and further leads to a significantly higher consensus within the annotators. Finally, a manual inspection revealed that events usually span more than 1 second, but multiple events could occur within a 3-second interval. Now we talk about VidC2 dataset statistics. VidC2 is a large-scale movie dataset covering 3,000 movies and spanning 29,000 clips. This corresponds to over 80 hours of richly annotated video data. The clips in VidC2 are quite diverse, with examples of distinct verb senses and unique entities. In particular, there are over 224 verbs appearing in at least 100 events and 336 unique entities in at least 100 videos. Even videos with shared locations depict widely different situations. This ensures the model cannot take shortcuts by looking at only background scene information. The curated videos are also complex, with multiple unique verbs and entities occurring within the same video. Over 80% of the videos contain at least 4 unique verbs, and over 70% of the videos have at least 6 unique entities. Here, we show examples of videos with 5 unique verbs and different number of entities. As such, most videos have multiple related events or situations occurring within the same video. And finally, videos in VidC2 are richly annotated. Our annotation includes verbs and semantic roles captured at every 2-second interval as shown here. The same entities appearing in different events are also co-referenced, shown by highlighted bars. Moreover, event relation with respect to event 3 are classified into 4 categories. On average, VidC2 has 3.8 role annotations for every event. Further, the coreference entities appear 2 to 5 times across entire video. To support robust evaluation, we procure validation and test set in 2 stages. In the first stage, we obtain 10 verbs for each 2-second event. Then, the most frequent set of verb senses are further supported with 3 semantic role annotations and event relations. We evaluate video SRL in 3 stages and present strong baseline models for each of them. For work prediction, we use the usual video classification pipeline where we segment a video into events and classify them individually. The classification model can be any action recognition model such as I3D or SlowFast. For semantic role prediction, we contextualize the features obtained from the action recognition model across the entire video using a transformer encoder model. These contextualized features are then used as an input to a decoder model which generates the required sequence of arguments joined with tokens. The resulting sequence can be post-processed to obtain phrases for each argument. Finally, for event relation classification, we use a text encoder model to encode the verbs as well as the arguments and use contextualized features from action recognition model. These are passed through a classification layer to produce the event relations. To evaluate the three tasks, we use the following metrics. For verb prediction, we resort to accuracy at 1 and 5, which checks if the top k predictions are present in the 10 ground truths. We also introduce recall at 5, which measures for each of the ground truth verbs if they are present in the top 5 predicted verbs, and then we average them across all verb classes. For semantic role prediction, we utilize CIDR for phrases and support averaging across verbs and arguments. For co-referencing, we utilize LEA, a link-based co-reference metric. We also introduce soft LEA, which combines CIDR scores with the links present in the LEA to obtain a combined phrase and co-reference metric. Finally, for event prediction, we utilize a macro average accuracy, which averages the accuracy over the four classes. Now we present our results and takeaways. For verb prediction task, we show results using I3D and SlowFast network with and without pre-training over Kinetics 400 and focus on the recall metric. As is evident, pre-training on Kinetics is very helpful, especially for better recall. For semantic roles, we compare GPT-2 model and transformer-based models. In particular, we compare against language-only decoder, a video language decoder without encoding, and finally a video language encoder decoder model. In general, we find that adding context across frames is very helpful, especially for co-referencing. For event relation prediction, we compare using a language-only, video-only, and video with verb and argument model. As such, we find language information rarely helps in identifying the event relations. Currently, a significant gap exists between the best performing models and human performance. Try out your models on VETSETU and consider submitting them to our leaderboards, which will remain open even after the ActivityNet workshop deadline. Our VETSETU paper is titled Visual Semantic Role Labeling for Video Understanding and is available on archive. Our code and dataset are public with baseline implementations and evaluation scheme. Our leaderboards are live and will remain open. For any questions regarding the dataset, please feel free to reach out to Arka. And thank you for listening.